Hey guys, welcome back to my project. So today what I'm trying to do in this project is trilateration with the UWB module. Using trilateration, I'd like to find the user's local position using straight line distances from three points. When there are three anchors and one tag device, you can see the distance the tag is from each anchor device. By calculating the three distance data obtained here, the local position of the tag device can be calculated. UWB projects are a topic that is widely covered not only at the hobby level, but also at the academy level. Before the UWB module came out, many projects and papers tried this project using BLE's RSSI signal strengths. My goal here is to make this very simple with ESP32 and UWB modules. If you want to cover this at an academic level, I recommend reading the paper. There are already many highly cited UWB papers that contain a lot of experimental data and will be very helpful for your new topic. Let's say there's one anchor and one tag, we can get one radius value. In other words, the tag location can be guessed to be somewhere around the circumference of the orange circle. Let me add one more anchor here. Adding another anchor creates another circle with a radius equal to the distance between the anchor and the tag. And there's an intersection where the two circles meet. We can predict the tag is located where the two circles intersect. It is not possible to pinpoint the user's location with a much higher probability than ever before. If one more anchor is added, a point where the three circles intersect will be created and the location of the tag can be clearly specified. Now let's look at the equation. The equation of a circle with radius R1, R2, and R3 for each anchor is as follows. Now let's combine the two equations of a circle to find the equation that passes through the intersection of the two circles. The equation that passes through the intersection of anchor 1 and anchor 2 is as follows. Since the expression becomes complicated in the subsequent calculations, I will replace each term with an alphabet. The replaced terms are as follows. The unknown x and y that we need to find refer to the x and y coordinates of the tag. The tag's coordinates can be obtained by combining the two equations above. Based on this, we can calculate the position of the tag. Let's think of the floor in my garage as a 2D coordinate plane. First, I set the center of the garage as 0,0 and install the anchors at both corners of the garage and the back way. After that, I was able to get the local coordinates of the anchors like this. Can I really get the current local coordinates 0,0 by doing this? If I rewrite the formula we derived earlier in Python, it will look like this. Update the R values obtained from each anchor. As a result of the calculation, I was able to obtain an approximation close to 0,0. As I said at the beginning, in this project, I will calculate trilateration on the tag device and display it on the connected display. So the Python code was changed to C++ format, and through this, the local position of the tag can be calculated. These are the devices used in this project. This is a UWB board based on ESP32. Three of them operate as anchors and two have already been coded to operate as tags. Perhaps in my next project, I can show you how multiple tags work. This UWB module has its pros and cons. ESP32 is not directly connected to DW3000, but transfers necessary data through serial communication with STM32. Therefore, only predefined commands can be used. This makes the system very simple, but it does not allow us to use all the features of DW3000. That's why this can only be used for very simple projects. Alright, it's time for some fun testing. As you can see here, there are three anchors placed. When I approach each anchor with my tag device, I want to check the distance data that is incoming from each anchor device. On the right side of the screen, you can see a graph showing distance data obtained from three anchor devices in real time. As I approach the first anchor device, the blue line is rapidly closer to zero. On the other hand, it was confirmed that the green line was rising as it moved away from the third anchor device. Now I move to the second anchor device on the right. The blue line is now moving away and the orange line is now closer to zero. This shows that every time I move the tag device, I can see how the values obtained from each anchor react and check whether it is operating normally. Here, we are checking the local position of the tag device. You can check approximate local positioning using the X and Y displayed on the screen. The place where I initially stood was 0,0 in local coordinates. As I go forward, Y increases, and as I go backward, Y decreases. This time, let's go to the first anchor. As I move to the left, X decreases. Also, because I moved forward, Y is increasing. This time, I'm going to the second anchor. Because I'm heading to the right side, X is increasing. If I move back to where I started, I'm getting closer to 0,0. Here, I created it using pure distance data without using any filters. I think that if I add a filter like the Kalman filter, I can get more stable data. I will have to try that later. In this project, I tried data acquisition and basic trilateration. Perhaps in the next project, it'll be fun to visualize this in the Unity environment and check it in real time. Alright, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.